crucified as the eternal Son of living God. They demand Muhammad is false prophet, and from his grave, Muhammad is going to come after them. Not good at all. But let me tell you about what Lord Jesus Christ tells you.
Because he's got to listen.
I tell you the truth. The Son can do nothing by himself. He can only do what he sees his Father is doing. Because whatever the Father does, the Son also does. Whatever Father does, Son also does the same thing. Anyone curious whatever Father does? No worries. Jesus tells us the things Father does and the things Jesus does. For the Father loves the Son and shows him all he does. Yes, to your amazement, he will show him even greater things than this. For just as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, life to whom he pleases to give. God the Father gives life to whom? To dead people. The ones who cannot breathe anymore. The ones identified as the dead, God gives them life. Eternal Son of God, Lord Jesus Christ says, I give them life too. Death becomes alive. How? Because Lord Jesus Christ, eternal Son of God, gives them life. And what it says? Whom he pleases. Whom he pleases. What kind of power must Lord Jesus Christ have to give life? Can you give life to dead? I can't. Even medical people can't give life to those people who are suffering from the coronavirus. Lord Jesus Christ says, I give them life. I raise the dead. Once you were dead, but now you are alive. Why? Because I, as the eternal Son of God, I am raising to dead. Let's continue. Allahu al-Askar. Allah is the Mr. Mouse. For just as the Father raises the dead and gives them life, even so the sons give life to whom he pleases to give. Moreover, the Father judges none, but he trusted all the judgment to Son. What kind of attributes someone must able to have to judge all? Your wife doesn't even know what you are up to. You don't even know what is your wife up to. You don't even it is serious. You don't even remember what you up to 10 years ago. You can't even judge yourself. But Lord Jesus Christ is able and capable to judge you. Not only you, but all of us. He knows what you've done when you were 5 years old. He knows what Mr. Policeman did a couple of months ago. He knows what Taliban is doing and what Taliban did and what Taliban will do. And he is going to judge. For someone to be able to judge, they must be all-knowing, all-powerful, and all-present. And Lord Jesus Christ says, I am that one who is going to raise the dead, and I am that one who is going to judge the all. Moreover, the Father judges no one, but he has trusted all judgment to Son, and all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. However you honor the God today, however you honor the Father today, Lord Jesus Christ says, I want the same thing. The way as a Christian we honor God, we worship him, we pray to him, we call upon his name. And Lord Jesus Christ says, do this to me. You've got to do these things to me. Worship me, pray me, praise me, give me all the adoration. position. The way you honor the father, now you've got to honor the son. Who does not honor the son does not honor the father who sent him. If you fail to today acknowledge who is Lord Jesus Christ, parent, there is sadness. Father doesn't know who you are. If you fail to acknowledge, if you fail to worship the King of Kings, Alpha and Omega, then Father doesn't know you. What is the basic implication? What is the basic implication? Well, I can't remember where it comes from, but what is the basic implication? Basic implication is, if you want to have life in its fullness, if you want to live your life by satisfied in its fullness, what you've got to do is, you need to look up to Lord Jesus Christ. You need to honor Lord Jesus Christ. That's all he's asking you. The one who created you, the one who knows what you've done last week, what you've done 10 years ago, and what you will do in 10 months, wants your worship to him. And he's very serious when he asks that. And he showed this seriousness when he gave himself on the cross for people like him and people like me. Muslims are mocking today that my God end up in the tummy of the woman and become a baby. Muslims are mocking that. It is a humiliation according to them. But it is the most humble event ever. King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Creator of universe, the one who holds the universe by the power of his word, willing to step into this world, not as a king, not as a warrior, but as a baby. Not only that, grows and gives his life on the cross for people like me who deserves nothing. Why? He does that out of grace, for love for me. What do you expect from me? Just turn my way and take the other direction? No. When the King of Kings steps into this world, he gets your full attention. And he wants your full attention. He doesn't want half of your heart. He doesn't want 30% of your heart. He wants all of you, because he gave all of himself for you. Therefore, look at the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of Kings, eternal Son of living God, and give your adoration, give your praises, give your honor to him. On the day of judgment, he is the one who is seated on the throne to judge you. What does he say? What does he say? Father, judge no one, but I am the one who is going to judge. And you think that's funny? I wish you can laugh when you stand in front of the Lamb of God, sir. Let me tell you why you won't be able to laugh when you stand in front of the Lamb of God. Then the King of Kings, then the kings of the earth, the princesses, the generals, the rich, the mighty, and every slave, every free man, hid in the caves and among the rocks of the mountains. They called the mountains and rocks, fall on us and hide us from the face of him who sits on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb. You won't be laughing, sir, on the day of judgment. You won't be laughing on that day. You will be asking mountains and the rocks to hide you. Those of you who rejected the work of Lamb of God, those of you who rejected identity of the Son of God, on the day of judgment, you will be crying to the rocks and mountains for help. My hope and my prayer is, before that. Before that, you will able to ask Lord Jesus Christ for his help, and you will able to bow down to him. Scripture doesn't make jokes. It is very serious when Scripture says one day every knee will bow down to Lord Jesus Christ. Every knee, my knees, willingly or unwillingly, will bow down to Lord Jesus Christ. I am Christian. My knees will bow down to Lord Jesus Christ willingly. But those of you who rejected the identity and work of Son of Living God, your knees will be forced to get down. You are going to bow down, but that's not going to be willingly. And every tongue is going to confess that Christ is the Lord. Every tongue. Tongue of Muhammad, pieces, police and FBI be upon him. Not met police, but FBI be upon him. He is going to confess Lord Jesus Christ. That's going to happen one day, willingly or unwillingly. We want it to be willingly, because heart of God is so big, he wants to have you home. Heart of God is so big, the Son of God gave himself for you on the cross by crucifixion. And grave couldn't hold him. Coronavirus is not going to hold him. Met police is not going to hold him. Mr. Muslim man is not going to hold him. Grave couldn't hold him. And he wants your heart. He wants you to turn to him and then respond to his proposal of if you want to be with him. Of course, it is optional. No one is forcing anyone in this world. In the next world, willingly or unwillingly, you will bow down to Lord Jesus Christ.